So this is a concept that we're going to be able to apply in lots of different settings when we have infinite hypothesis classes. And this is really the fundamental way that it's used. Except usually there's kind of a more technical sounding definition. This notion of labeling in all possible ways is usually termed shattering. So this quantity that we're talking about here, this size of the largest set of inputs that the hypothesis space can shatter, is called the VC dimension.
What does VC stand for?
VC stands for Vapnik-Chervinenkis, which is a pair of actual people. So, you know, really smart, insightful guys that put together this notion of a definition. And what they did is they can relate the VC dimension of a class to the amount of data that you need to be able to learn effectively in that class. So as long as this dimensionality is finite, even if the hypothesis class is infinite, we're going to be able to say things about how much data we need to learn. So that's really cool. It really connects things up beautifully. So I think what would be a really useful exercise now is to look at various kinds of hypothesis classes and for us to measure the VC dimension.
Okay, sounds like fun.